So if you want to assess the insect population that's present in the field, you don't just want to rely on taking visual estimates and walking through the field. You really want to get yourself a sweep net. This is a tool that we use to actually sample the canopy and see what insects are out there and how many of them are out there. You swing this down through the entire canopy. You want to make sure that the net stays open. You want to make sure that the top of the net goes down below the soybean canopy. You don't want to swing your net through like this where the insects can fall out in front of the net. You actually want to make sure that the angle of the net is either even or a little bit in front of the direction you're sweeping, like that, so that you actually catch the insects that are falling down off of that canopy. There's several suppliers you can pick these up from online. You want to make sure you get a sweep net that's 15 inches in diameter. It comes in either a polyester or a cloth material. I tend to like to use the polyester because it dries out more quickly. You'll see in a second here, this soybean canopy is very wet. If you're sweeping early in the morning, it's usually very wet. With a cloth net, that sort of interferes with your ability to use it again before it dries out. The disadvantage of this polyester material, it's very light. Some people like to use the cloth because you get a little more heft through that canopy. You get a little more power. And it is something you don't want to swing this through there too light. If you're doing this correctly, you're going to pick up a little bit of leaf tissue in the base of the net. If you swing it too lightly through there, you're not going to get a good, accurate assessment of the insect population that you have. You want to make sure that you're using this tool correctly and consistently so that you can compare your numbers from field to field and from week to week. One of the advantages of a sweep net over some other sampling tools is that you can use this either in wide rows or narrow rows. So if you're looking at a 30-inch row or greater, you're going to target your sampling to a single row. If you're going below 30 inches, if you're at a 15-inch or a drilled row, you're just going to take as long of a sweep, you know, as wide as a swath through the canopy as you can. The other thing you want to make sure, and you saw that I was throwing some leaves around on a few of those sweeps, you want to try to collect all that leaf tissue in the net. You don't want leaves flying back and forth as you swing the net through. You want to pull these leaves out fairly slowly. You don't necessarily want to miss anything as you're going through this net. See here the Japanese beetle, another common defoliating insect in soybeans. Our Japanese beetle populations right now are starting to wind down, but there's still a few stragglers left out there in the field. These damsel bugs can bite if you were to handle them, so you want to be careful about touching them. Not terribly painful, but not a lot of fun to be bitten by one either. You see, there's one of our green stink bugs. So yeah, you notice that while these green stink bugs are very easy to find out here in the field, again, the threshold for those is 9 per 25 sweeps. We're not close to needing to treat for these stink bugs out there in the field. And that's why this sweep net can be such an effective tool. It tells you not just what's there, but how many and how close you are to needing an actual insecticide application. You can also see how wet this net is. When you're finished, you shake that off, take a few swings with it, and then this polyester net's ready to go again.